All right, guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to be learning about a little more complicated project. It's called Stellar, or XLM. Here is on coinmarketcap.com. Oh, well, before we start, if you want to learn how to get some free Stellar, or if you want to learn more about this cryptocurrency, I'll leave a link in the description of this where you can go to Coinbase. They have a couple of very informative videos with several pictures, so it's pretty easy to read and pretty easy to see. There's like 6 or 5 2-minute videos, and they'll send you free Stellar for watching it, and all in the description where you can go to Coinbase to get some XLM for free and some Stellar just for learning about the ecosystem. It's pretty cool. It's a really neat project. It is a little complicated, but I like to basically relate it to like this. So you have a box and you want to mail it to someone. Your Stellar Lumens, or the Stellar of the ecosystem, is going to be that box. The actual product you put inside there is going to be the asset that is basically being tokenized. That's also a term that they use. So you're going to ship it to the person. They open the box. Inside the box, it has the asset. That's it. So that's how Stellar Lumens works. It gets rid of the intermediary, or that third party like the bank. If you traditionally send money to someone else in another country and they have pesos or euros and you're trying to send US dollars, you have to send US dollars, you have to go to your bank, your bank has to go to their bank, then they have to transact and from US dollars to pesos or to euros, then from those euros or to that bank that's over there, they have to send it to the local bank that the customer has, then they get it in their bank, and then it sends it to the customer. And by the time they get the money, it's almost a week later, and they've lost half of it because all the banks take out all the fees. And with some countries, with some of their currencies, they're inflating the money so much that their money could be half the value of that. So they lost out on the exchange, and they lost out on the time value of money. So this is a great project for that. It's almost like the middle of the in-between of XRP and synthetics. So XRP is for big industries and big banks. It allows banks to send money to other banks quick, easy, and for a low price. That's why everyone raves about XRP and says it's so great. But it's more so for the institutions. So with Stellar, this is also for, I guess you can say, the people or non-institutional. So with Stellar, not only can you tokenize money, but you can also tokenize assets. So you can tokenize your house, you can tokenize a car. I mean, it's limitless, which is also what synthetics does. But synthetics is more so for commodities. Like, it'll tokenize gold, it'll tokenize oil, it'll tokenize wheat, eggs, soy. It'll tokenize anything that mainly trades in like futures on the commodities market. So this is just like an intro to Stellar. This is talking about what Stellar stands for. You can read more about it on stellar.org, and you can just visit the website to see the different things. So Stellar launched in 2015, over 4 million individual accounts. This has been growing. There used to be a total supply of 100 billion, but since then that has been cut in half. So now there's only about 50 billion total tokens that will ever be created. Currently there is like a supply of about 20 billion. Or 21 billion. Here's an example of what it does. So here's a traditional dollar. Then it goes through, I guess, the tokenizing process. They have anchors. It's almost like the bank, but for the Stellar Lumen system. Then it creates the dollar token, which is the Stellar, or not the Stellar, but the tokenized asset you're looking at. The Stellar Lumens are used for mainly the bad actors, So there's people that will try to spam the system and double spin. So with the Stellar Lumens, it creates a monetary value to each transaction. So that way it's kind of like, oh, if the spammer's really trying to spam the network, I mean, eventually if he spams it a bunch of times, it's going to cost him a lot of money. So that's the reason why they finally instituted the Stellar Lumens, or used the Stellar Lumens as like a fee for the bad actors, or to keep that from happening. So these are the different people that build on Stellar. They have several different partners. You can read more about this. This is just an introductory, just to say, hey, look, the Stellar project, you should take a look. I really think it's a very disruptive technology, and it's a very good project. This is Stellar right now. It's actually up big time. So here it was only about a penny. Again, this is not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm just telling you about different cryptocurrencies, and you can learn about them by yourself. But this is back in 2017. It started at a cent and shot all the way up to about 80 cents, almost a dollar. That was back in the Bitcoin bubble, and dropped since then, and dropped down to about 8 cents, and now it's back up to about 20 cents. But a lot of people are jumping on the bandwagon right now because XRP is exploding right now. It literally went up 150-200%. So this is a quick explanation. Put simply, Stellar is an open network that allows money to be stored, or to be moved and stored when it's released. When it was released in July 2014, one of the goals was boosting financial inclusion by reaching the world's unbanked, which is for just normal people. Like institutions, they don't have a problem getting banking, but like for normal people, this is the huge part about cryptocurrency, is you can be your own banker now, which is great. So it kind of talks to you about it. It's a very simple project, upfront with the concept of what it's trying to do, basically allowing you to transact money to another country with little to no fees whatsoever. See, originally based on the Ripple Labs protocol, which is also XRP, so that's probably why it's similar to XRP, but it is not XRP. It's a separate project. So that's good. Jed Michaela, big founder in the XRP. XRP was one of the, well, Ripple is also XRP, and one of the big founders of it, or helped building the system. So you definitely have a lot of brains behind the project, so that's definitely a plus. It's not something that's just created and made out of nowhere. This is something that was thought up to solve a problem that we were having. So this is a little bit about the assets of the anchors. You can watch a video here. Here's a link right here, luminauts.com. I can leave a link in the description as well. Basically how it works is with the anchors, it works like a triangle like this. So you have, this could be me, this could be you, this could be another person putting in that cryptocurrency or that digital asset here. So this is where the swap occurs. So I'm putting in, let's say, Bitcoin. Now it's going to whatever dollar I want. Let's say I want to tokenize a dollar, or tokenize it to a dollar, or tokenize it to anything. It turns it into that token. Now that bank then takes that token, issues you a credit, says, hey, look, you got $10 worth of this, or you have 10 euro worth of this. And then the bank distributes it to any of the other parties that are looking to get the withdrawal, or that you're sending it to. Then you now have a credit, so you can also do the same thing. Hey, I want to exchange my credit and get my money back. Okay, so great. So now the bank sends you your money back, and you then become this person over here. Or the same thing on the other end. You have someone trying to send a credit card payment, etc. So it's a very simple project up front, but there's a lot more details involved. But the main thing you need to know is it's solving the problem of sending one currency into another with as little fees as possible. So here is another very interesting part of the Stellar network. This is why it makes it so disruptive as well, is it has its own exchange. So this is the current rate for like the dollar to dollar, or you can go the Nigerian to the dollar, etc. So you can instantly change it. It's a very easy app to use. So this sends money to different currencies overseas or in other countries within seconds. It's crazy how fast it works, but you can even exchange assets. So like if you see this, like this guy's trying to exchange BTC for gold, you can exchange it, boom. So it's almost like the synthetics network. You can trade, you can send a euro for a dollar. Well, that's also trading, so the same thing. It even allows micropayments, which normally if you were to send like a dollar overseas, you're going to be paying crazy fees. But here in this scenario, you can pay 5 cents and the fees are so minimal. It's 0.0001 lumens, I believe it is, which is like fractions of a penny. It's crazy cheap, but very good partners. IBM's one of them, huge partner. So IBM's taking on this technology. Is trying to use it to help their system as well. So they have a lot of backers, a lot of partners. There's some projects that are just built on the Stellar network. Satoshi Pay, Saldo, Tempo, and Calvary. You can visit the different sites. Here's some of the wallets you can store it on. Ledger Nano S, definitely recommend that. There's tons of wallets, so you can also even just do it on simple wallets like your Atomic wallet or even on an exchange. I don't recommend keeping it on an exchange, but if you're trying to make a quick trade or trade it for something else, that's where you do it for the best rates. So if you guys have any questions or would like me to do another video or on a specific cryptocurrency you guys want me to go over, I'd be more than happy to take a look at it and do a video on it to help explain it better. You can also leave a comment and I'll respond to your comment with any of the answers. But this is a pretty good project. I do like this project. Please like and subscribe if you like the video, and I'll be making more videos. Thanks for watching, guys.